This week, we are finishing the first part of our course about theories and methods of second language acquisition. We have seen very different language teaching methods. But so, in the end, what do we do? Well, the first question we have to ask ourselves is, are all methods relevant? Are all methods effective? If you followed closely, you know that no, not all methods are effective. The grammar translation method, in particular, really fails at making the students able to speak or to interact in the language they learned. They might be able to read, but even that is not always achieved. The other methods, maybe in theory, can be effective, but that does not mean that they are equally effective. We saw that the audiolingual method was relatively inefficient at developing an independent, fluent communicative ability. Learners only remembered very well the sentences they were taught, but they were not able to speak autonomously. This being said, we also have seen that there were certain interesting elements in various methods. The total physical response, for example, offers activities that work quite well with total beginners, to be actively engaged in the class before they can speak by themselves. There are also useful tools to reuse from TPRS and interesting principles and ideas from the natural approach or the silent way. But so, again, what do we do? Well, the solution is simply not to think in terms of methods. The method is not the solution. As Pennier wrote, language teaching should not be primarily based on method, but rather on a set of principles and procedures. And those principles and procedures are not fixed. They should be based on teachers' practical situated experience. In other words, each teacher knows from experience what works best with their students. And they should be enriched by research, theory, and practice. We are in a post-methods era. Since the beginning of the 2000s, many teachers and researchers have advocated an eclectic approach. The best teachers do not conform to one method only. They pick ideas and techniques from multiple methods and adapt them to their own teaching context. The communicative language teaching approach is quite flexible and it fits this eclectic approach very well. So you can be communicative and still use ideas from all the other methods if you think they're relevant. Now, even though we are in a post-methods era, it doesn't mean that everything works equally well and that everything is acceptable. So how do we decide what works? A worldwide tendency today is what we call evidence-based practice. This means that the practitioner decides, based on scientific findings, based on scientific evidence, what should work best. And this does not only occur in teaching. It is actually very important in other fields, and it's prominent in medicine. Many doctors make their recommendations and decisions based on science, not only the things they learned at university, but also more recent findings published in the scientific journals. But if you have tried to look at research publications, you might have had the impression that there were so many different directions, so many different ideas, that they are not always consistent. For instance, if we remain in the field of medicine, you might find a study that demonstrates that drinking coffee is beneficial for the heart, and then another study that says that coffee is actually bad in terms of health. So again, how do we decide? In language teaching, how do we determine if it's better to use flashcards, vocabulary lists, or something else? Well, there is one great answer to these questions: a meta-analysis. What is a meta-analysis? It is a study that summarizes many other studies, quantitative studies, on a particular topic and computes a kind of average effect from all the data of all these studies. Let's go back to the coffee example. A meta-analysis on the health effects of coffee will find all the previous studies on coffee, put their results into a statistical model, and have one definitive answer that will be much more reliable and strong than any of the previous individual studies. If you're interested, there actually have been multiple meta-analyses on the effects of coffee consumption, and they all tend to confirm that coffee, at least in reasonable amounts, 2 to 4 cups per day, is beneficial for multiple health conditions and reduces mortality. Now, what about teaching then? Well, there have been thousands of meta-analyses in language teaching and in education in general. I could really not summarize all the results here, but there is one author I want to briefly cover today, John Hattie. John Hattie did a meta-analysis. He took 1,400 meta-analyses in education, including over 80,000 studies and 300 million students, and summarized all the effects observed in education from all these meta-analyses. So what are his conclusions? I recommend you to read his publications called Visible Learning to have a better idea. Still, very briefly, what we can say is he observed that certain techniques are much more effective than others. For instance, providing feedback to learners leads to high effects. One of the most effective interventions a school can implement is providing tutoring and personal help as soon as possible to any struggling student. What Hattie also demonstrates is that certain actions we might have thought would have a strong impact on learning outcomes actually have only very weak effects. For instance, giving homework to students is only weakly effective. Reducing the size of the class also has only a mild effect. And some things have simply no effect at all. For instance, Hattie shows that background music has neither a positive nor a negative impact on learning. There are too many findings to discuss all these here, but I recommend you look closely at the results of research, and in particular the results of meta-analysis, to decide what works and what does not work in your own teaching. Hattie's book is a great place to start. That is also what we will consider in the following parts of this course, where we will try to look at what do we know about the different parts of language teaching that work best. See you then.